the debate over imposition of Hindi is back in focus after Home Minister Amit Shah's statement on Hindi Divas. And joining me on this broadcast is Karthi Chidambaram, Congress MP from Shivaganga. Karthi, what do you make of what Mr. Amit Shah said on Hindi Divas, that Hindi is a unifier in the country?
See, Hindi is definitely not a unifier in this country. Hindi is definitely not the national language. And this issue is not necessarily a Hindi versus Tamil issue. It is about accepting the regional differences and allowing states to function within their identity and to keep and to preserve their identity. This debate has been raging in Tamil Nadu for over 50 years. And the politics of Tamil Nadu has in fact been formed and shaped because of this attempt by the central government. I know the central government at that time could have been the Congress government, the attempt by the central government to impose Hindi and Tamil Nadu. And again, the BJP has got much more sinister designs. And it's not just one language. Eventually, they want to make this country into a one language, one religion, one kind of identity country. And this is just a first step towards that. And secondly, Hindi is not an aspirational language for the people of Tamil Nadu. It is not. English is the aspirational language of the people of Tamil Nadu. So why are you forcing a three-language formula when a two-language formula works very well within Tamil Nadu and it's been working well for the last 50 years? Why this again this new thrust right now? It's only part of this larger design of this Hindi-Hindustan design of the BJP.
No, but Karthi, you know, when you say that there is an imposition of Hindi, the question is how? How do you believe the BJP government is trying to push forward its agenda of imposing Hindi on southern states? Even the three-language policy, for example, they're not replacing a language. They're only adding one more. So what is really the harm in learning another language?
No. There's no harm in learning another language. Please be very clear. If somebody wants to learn a language voluntarily, it's a decision which must be left to the parents if the children are very young or to the students themselves. There's no reason for the central government to step in and say, you learn three languages. And I have another position. I don't believe that English is a foreign language in India anymore. I think English is as much as an Indian language as any other language. It's been around for 200 years here. I mean, Indians produce literature in English. I mean, they produce scientific papers in English. They communicate in English. Your channel thrives on the fact that many people understand and speak English. So why is English still considered a foreign language? I mean, that's the point. You know, they say, two languages must be Indian languages and one could be a foreign language. And in my opinion, the two Indian languages could be Tamil and English itself. So why should Hindi, English be considered a foreign language? I think that debate is also very important. Many people speak about it. I think the time has come for us to just say English is as much as an Indian language. There are lots of people in India for whom English is the primary language of communication. And even at home, a lot of people speak English. And English is the aspirational language of the of Indians. It is a language of science. It is a language of commerce. And that's the only way,
way forward.
And it also gives great social mobility for people who have been oppressed. And Hindi is not the aspirational language for anybody. And
but
it's
do you
not,
not
going
believe,
to give any kind of social mobility.
Do you not believe that for people in the South, for example, if they want to move to even a Delhi and work, it helps to know Hindi, and that's the simple point.
Sure. If somebody wants to get a job in Delhi, or somebody wants to move to Delhi, they are free to learn Hindi. Please understand, we are not opposing anybody learning Hindi. What we are opposing is making Hindi a compulsory language, either directly or indirectly by proposing a three-language formula. And this business of giving directives to the central government ministries to say, you know, propagate Hindi in your own offices when you are operating in a state which is not a Hindi-speaking state. You know, give me files only in Hindi. I'm making a Hindi development officers, posting quote-unquote Hindi development officers in each department. This is the problem. The problem is not if somebody wants to learn Hindi or somebody wants to learn Mandarin, they're absolutely free to learn any language. Nobody is preventing them from doing that. But it must be voluntary. It can't be compulsory. And I'm again reiterating, Hindi, by and large, is not an aspirational language for anybody in Tamil Nadu. If somebody desires to work in another state, they will learn whatever language it takes them, it makes them for efficient functioning there. The same way, vice versa, if somebody wants to come to Tamil Nadu and do trade in a rural area, they probably will learn Tamil, but it's not compulsory.
You know what, Karthi, in the last few years, we've seen a lot of politics over this issue that's even forced Amit Shah, I remember last year, to come out with the clarification that they're not trying to really ensure that Hindi trumps over any other language. Having said that, the politics that we see over this issue, particularly in the run-up to the Tamil Nadu elections, do you believe that somewhere it also creates a negative sentiment among people in Tamil Nadu? There is a certain notion right now that in Tamil Nadu, if you speak Hindi, you'll be targeted because of this narrative that's been created.
Have there been instances of people being targeted because they speak Hindi in Tamil Nadu?
No, absolutely not.
then I mean, there have been people who have been targeted in the rest of India for eating certain
things. My question is there a narrative that's being created by politicians for political gains?
I would say that is part of the BJP's narrative to come up with a Hindustan version of India. And we are very, and you see, it's not just, in northern India, languages like Bhojpuri, Rajasthani, Haryanvi, Sindhi are all getting obliterated because of Hindi. You see, those people don't protest enough because they understand Hindi and they're not seeing what this Hindi imposition is doing to their own language and culture. Whereas for us, our language is much more distinctly different from Hindi. So we realize the kind of pressures which are being put on us by Hindi and by the Home Minister. I mean, I read a report saying that all files put to the Home Minister are translated into Hindi. So if tomorrow there is another Home Minister who does not, from the southern states, where like we had a Home Minister from the past, he can't read these files. He needs to get them retranslated.
So, Karthi, then, for people who say that Hindi is a national language, that everyone in the country needs to know Hindi, I want a message from you to those people, and I want you to say it in Tamil. I'll translate if need be, but I want you to give out that message in Tamil to them.
India-udaiya desiya mozhi Hindi alla. India-vile pala mozhigal undu. Ella mozhigalukkum mukkiyathum thara vendum. Anal samudayathile munnera vendum. உலக அளவிலே பொருளாதார ரீதியாகவும் விஞ்ஞான ரீதியாகவும் வளர வேண்டும் என்றால் அதற்கு ஆங்கிலம் தான் உகந்த மொழி. ஆனால் இன்னும் ஆங்கிலத்தை ஒரு அந்நிய மொழியாக கருதுவதை என்னால் ஏற்றுக்கொள்ள முடியாது. ஆங்கிலத்தையும் ஒரு இந்திய மொழியாக ஏற்றுக்கொள்ள வேண்டும். தமிழகத்திற்கு தமிழும் ஆங்கிலமுமே போதும். யாருக்காவது ஹிந்தி பேச வேண்டும் என்று விரும்பினார்கள் என்றால் அவர்கள் தாராளமாக பேசலாம். ஆனால் அரசு ஆணையிட்டு நீங்கள் கட்டாயமாக பேச வேண்டும் என்பதை என்றும் தமிழ்நாடு ஏற்றுக்கொள்ளாது.
Okay, Karthi, Nandri, thank you for joining us here in India today. Karthi's message at the end in Tamil was essentially what he'd said earlier, that Hindi is a language that people should choose to speak. Don't impose it on anyone. For people of Tamil, what matters is English and Tamil. For people who want to learn Hindi, they can. Don't impose it is the message. Thank you, Karthi, for joining us. Tossing it back to Pooja Shali for more news updates.
Hi, everyone. Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.